Hello, I'm back. Welcome to the TV NerdKnits podcast. It's been a really long time. I don't remember the last time that I recorded. It's been months, possibly half a year. I don't know. It's been a really long time. I was planning on recording today. Today is February 2nd, 2017. What? And coincidentally, I received an email from a viewer asking about the podcast and, you know, commenting that it's been a long time since I've uploaded a new video and asked if I was still doing it. And I was like, well, I was planning on doing that today for the first time in forever. Anyways, if you are a new viewer, or even if you're a returning viewer, may I remind you, I'm Megan Sanders. I'm also known as Zevril on Ravelry and TVNerdKnits on Instagram. And this is the TVNerdKnits podcast. And so some update. There's plenty to talk about. I haven't done this in a really long time, so I think the last time I recorded, I think I had mentioned that I was recently diagnosed with Graves' disease, which is a hyperthyroid autoimmune disorder. And I might have just talked about the early diagnosis. So I was still kind of in the beginning stages, especially of trying to figure out my medicine and the dosage and everything. That was, gosh, when I found out, it was May of last year, 2016. And then I didn't get in to see my endocrinologist until June or July. And anyways, just now, you know, plenty of months later, just now, I think we have finally figured out the right medicine and dosage for me. I'm just now starting to feel almost normal the way I used to feel before all of this. So, yeah, that's good. It's just taken a really long time. Well, anywho, so I have done quite a bit of knitting since, and a lot of it was Christmas knitting, and I can't show off any of it. Oh, let me not get into that yet. Let's talk about the podcast. Yay, it's so unorganized, just like it used to be. anyways. On the podcast, this semester, January, I decided to go back to school and finish my degree. Yay! It has been 10 years last time I was in college. It's been 10 years. And, I wish I had finished back then. Let's just put it like that. Not only did it seem easier in a way it kind of seems easier now, just because I know I'm much more familiar with the material already, you know, so far. So that's the easy part. The hard part is catching up with your family, because I have two young boys, two toddlers, you know, and so it's hard scheduling, and also having my yarn business, it's hard juggling the school, the business, and my family all at the same time. So, yeah, 10 years ago, I wish I had finished college back then when I didn't have any of those obligations except for school. and also the tuition cost. Wow. I was telling my mother that, 10 years ago, a whole, like a 12-hour, 15-hour, full class loaded semester costs as much as one class costs now. And so, yeah. anyways, no wonder there was the whole, protesting and everything about that a couple of years ago. But anyways, so yeah, I'm back in school, and so the podcasts, I don't know. I'm gonna try to keep up with it, but they might be just a monthly thing, just a once a month recording. I don't know. We'll see. anywho, yeah. I'm a blithering idiot, just like I was back when I recorded last time. Yay. Anywho, so let's get into the knitting, shall we? I've had several FOs, like I was saying. I did knit a bit since the last time I recorded. And they were all Christmas gifts. It seemed like for 3 months straight, it was nothing but gift knitting. Even though I started earlier than I did the previous year on my Christmas gift knitting, the first Christmas item I started with were socks from my brother, and if you remember from previous episodes, my brother wears a size 16 shoe. So, it takes a long time to knit those socks for him. So, anyway, he's very knit-worthy, so... it's not like I spent a lot of time on an exorbitant amount of time on knitting these socks for Bigfoot, and they go unappreciated. He definitely appreciates them, so it makes it worth it. But since it took so long on his, it's just anyways. Oh, and I forgot to get out a whip. I think I don't have it in the. In here in the living room with me either. No, I don't. And I'm not going to edit, so. Anywho. So, anyways. I technically have 3 whips going on. But Owen got 2 sitting beside me. Sorry. Maybe next episode. anyways, it's been the whip that's missing has been put on the back burner anyways for now. Actually, everything's been put on the back burner while I try to hurry up and finish this one sweater that I will show you. But anyways, so FO, the only one I have to show out of all the FOs that I have completed since the last recording is this one, and it's my new design called Penny Shawl. It's part of the ladies from the Big Bang Theory collection, kind of. The Amy shawl, after Amy Farrah Fowler character, is in testing right now. Scarf is not a shawl, sorry. But this is the Penny shawl. I really love it. I get so many compliments on this whenever I wear it. A ton of compliments. And it's just, it really is. It's a nice, it's a worsted and fingering weight shawl. And basically I took my minis, and the minis are in a sock weight yarn, and then 2 skeins of worsted weight for the rest of the shawl. And I really love it. No, kitty, you cannot tear up my shawl. The cat is trying to attack it. Anyways, I'm hot. I'm not putting it back on. Speaking of a new work in progress, I'm trying to grab him, but he's currently biting me, little brat. We got a new cat. Say hi to Fiskers. No. You cannot call me little brat. He's a brat. He's sweet, except for this. He's a kitten. I guess, I don't know, how old do you think you are right now? Maybe maybe 7 or 8 months old now. We're not really sure. He hasn't had the snip snip yet. He is scheduled for that. Not next week, but the week after. He's scheduled for his snip snipping. And I am actually really looking forward to it since he likes to go and pee on my kids' clothes. My clothes, we have a captain's bed in our bedroom. And the way our captain's bed is not the drawer kind, it's like the basket kind. And there's enough room for him to like squeeze in there and get like on top of the baskets. And I put like, and you know, some baskets have like our extra sheeting, bed sheeting, and then like, and then my husband's socks, and one basket's just full of my pajamas, you know, stuff like that. All the rest of our clothes are hung up, but, yeah, the little brat gets on top of the basket and pees on them. Pees on all his clothes that are in the basket, and it just, ugh. Anyways, yes, you are a little brat. You're a brat, and you're being snipped. But he is sweet. Other than that, he's still... It's been a really long time since we've had a cat. My husband and I, we had a gray tabby. It was back when I went to college. And he was a stray cat. You know, he was never fixed. But, you know, we didn't have any problems with him going around spraying and peeing on things, doing the whole territory thing. That, like, you know, everyone, when we got this cat, everyone was like, you need to get him fixed. You need to get him fixed because he'll spray and stuff. And I was like, well, you know, Stinkers never did that ever at all. He was, of course, he also, Stinkers like to take baths. I kid you not. He loved to get bathed. Weirdest cat ever. But he was also, like, just the best cat ever. So I'm kind of biased, you know, he kind of spoiled me. So I had to keep that in mind with this new one because he's a little more cat-like. Go figure. But, yeah, he is a ginger or orange tabby. And he was also a stray. We were coming back from my in-laws, Thanksgiving, and it wasn't Black Friday, it was the Saturday right after Thanksgiving. We were coming back, and we were unloading our car, and anywho, he came around the corner, and he was all sweet and loving, and infested with fleas. He just had fleas crawling all over him, super skinny. He had tapeworm from the fleas, all sorts of issues. And you know, that kind of let us know that he was definitely a stray. He didn't like belong to a neighbor or anything. So we took him in, gave him a bath, gave him flea treatment and worm treatment, and anyways, but we went ahead and like posted his picture and stuff everywhere, all over Facebook and locally and stuff, saying that we found cat in case he was someone's around here, and he's never got claimed. And of course, my oldest son, who has been wanting a cat since he was 2 years old, he's now 5. He's been wanting a cat since he was 2, was just, you know, all about, you know, so we named him Fiskars, like, you know, the scissors. So he's the new addition to our family. I love him, but at the same time, he drives me nuts. But anywho, he keeps me company during the day because, you know, I'm a stay-at-home mom, and both my boys are in school, so. Anywho, so let's get on to the works in progress. This is going to be kind of a short episode, really. I mean, we're almost 15 minutes in, but I only have 2 works in progress to show. I don't have anything else to show. So, the first thing that I have, and I just started this. And hopefully I haven't lost stitches here because I didn't put my... needle protectors on the end to keep the stitches from falling off, but I need to get me one of those DPN cozies. I need to get one for this, but I have started, and I'm not that, this is the wrong sign. I have started the 10 stitch blanket, and it's with the leftover sock yarn. I happen to have my sock yarn mitered square blanket right here. I have actually decided that I am going to frog this. I'm going to rip it all out, and I'm going to use the magic knot method and just ball all of it up and put it into this instead. I cannot remember the lady's Ravelry name, but she had posted in one of the knitting groups that I belong to a picture of her completed sock yarn 10 stitch blanket, and I loved it so much, and I told her, I was like, wow, this is the most gorgeous one that I've seen, because, you know, anyone who's on Ravelry, I'm sure, has come across the 10 stitch blanket. And you know, and you can do it in any weight with any yarn, with any needle size. It doesn't matter. So, I mean, there's plenty of variations on the 10 stitch blanket. And I thought it was cool. The construction of it and everything is pretty awesome. But I just, you know, looking at everyone else's, I never really had the desire to make one until I saw hers. And I've seen where people have just taken, you know, the leftover, like, scrap yarn 10-stitch blanket. But the way she did hers is that she would do what would you call it? I guess line or the square or whatever. I don't know. Anyways, she would do, you know, the scrap yarn or leftover yarn, so like this right here is some leftover sock yarn, and then the next one would be a plain, a solid of whatever, and it would always stay the same, basically. My words make no sense, but I'm sure the visual right here makes complete sense to you. So, anyways, yeah. So I decided to do that. Actually, these right here are not, I didn't knit socks from this. This is from a minis swap that I never had, I just hadn't put into the other blanket yet. So I'm doing that right now. I have a few more to go before I have to start frogging my other sock yarn blanket. Anyways, yeah, I told one of my friends that I was going to do that, and she's like, but you're so far along on your squares, you know, you're really going to rip all of that out? And I'm really not, and actually, I'm not that far. I mean, not near as far as, like, you know, some other people. So it's not that big of a deal, and also, I didn't think I was going to end up liking the size that I was going to get from it. And I don't know, I saw that lady's 10-stitch blanket, and I was so in love with it, and I was like, yeah, I'm doing that. The other one looks like a quilt to me as well, but this one really reminds me of like especially on the edge where it shows the chain stitch combined. It's reminds me a lot of kind of like a what are they called? I'm not a quilter, so the rag quilt, I think is what they're called, where you see the edging, like, or the I'm not a sewer either. So, okay, let's just move on. If you know what I'm talking about, you know. If you don't know what I'm talking about, then you're as clueless as I am. So, anyways, but yeah, I'm not that far along on it. I just started it yesterday. And anywho, and I am housing that, and see, here's here are the bags of minis that I just haven't gotten to from the mini swap. And I'm housing it in the project, really big, huge project bags. One of two of the huge project bags that my sister-in-law made me a couple of Christmases ago. It was one of those where you pull the string and it cinches up, but my boys got a hold of it and somehow like snipped one side of the string or ribbon or whatever and pulled it out. So I'm gonna have to fix that, or however I do that. Maybe I should just take it to my sister-in-law and ask her to do it for me. But anyways, so yeah. Oh, and I was using, I never remember to do this, and I don't think to do it, but, you know, other podcasters do it a lot. I am using Knitter's Pride, actually, I've got the things still here. I'm using DPNs, and I'm knitting on size US 3.25 millimeters, and it's Knitter's Pride Nova Cubics. It's their square needles, and that's kind of like a bigger picture, close-up picture. Ignore my horrible fingernails. I'm plenty of manicure. Anyways, but yeah, I like using the DPNs for these kind of things. I use the DPNs on the other blanket too. But anyways, and it's not my first time using the cubics. I like them, especially for DPNs. I don't know what it is. Seems like I hold the needles better. They're not as, I don't know. I feel like I can, I mean, I like regular needles too, the regular round ones. But I like the square ones because it seems like I can go longer. Like I can knit for a much longer time on them before I start, getting fatigued. Mm-hmm. So, anywho, next whip. I don't remember what this looked like the last time I had shown it, but I am working on the Rosalie cardigan, the new sweater design that I'm doing for Leading Men Fiber Arts. They were generous enough to send me the yarn to design a cardigan out of, and this is on their Dramaturg, that's their DK 100% superwash merino base, and in the Lucky Charm colorway, which is this gorgeous green. This, it just does not do the color justice in this video, but as you can see, I have finished the body of the sweater, finally. I didn't think I was ever going to finish with the hem, the ribbing. We've got three and a half or 4 inches on the ribbing. I don't remember. I have to get out my measuring tape, but anyways, it took forever. And my model is a size small, so just imagine if I had to do it for, like, if I was knitting it for my size, I don't think I could get through it. And anyways, I'm working on the sleeves two at a time. I'm using 12-inch Chalgu needles for the circulars for the sleeves to do two at a time. Basically, what I'm doing is on one sleeve, I get to a decrease and then get to the next decrease and then, you know, match it up on the next sleeve and go up and decrease and just back and forth to do two at a time. And it's going. I can't remember when I started the sleeves. It wasn't that long ago. Basically, like the end of last week. And the goal is to get this thing finished by the end of Super Bowl, which is this Sunday. And yeah, that is the goal, to have this sweater finished by the time Super Bowl is over. And then that Monday, when I have the house to myself, I can concentrate enough to do the math and and write out the pattern for all the different sizes and stuff and get that ready for testing. So that is the goal. Don't know if that's going to happen. I told Steve at Lady Men Fiber Arts, he's one of the dyers, him and his partner Andy, and I was like, that, you know, surely I will have it done. I mean, it's getting fewer and fewer stitches as I continue to knit more and more decrease rounds, so it shouldn't be too much longer. It's just a matter of finding the knitting, the time to work on it, really, because I have schoolwork to do. And right now, basically tonight and all day tomorrow, I will be doing that schoolwork. I have a lot of reading to do and an assignment where I have to type up two different things for the same class and all that loveliness. To say that I didn't miss school is an understatement, I will say. It's deadlines that stress me out. If I don't have a deadline for anything, I'm good. You know, I love doing that stuff. But so you stick a deadline on there, it stresses me out. And, yeah, anyways. But life is full of deadlines, really. So I should really just buckle down and get used to it. But anyways, so, yeah, next time I record, that sweater should be finished. Now I don't know if I'll have it available to show though, because once it gets modeled, it will be going to my model. It'll be her sweater. So, anyways, so maybe I'll record before the modeling happens. But anywho, the other whip that I don't have to show you is it's a Christmas knit. It's gonna be a Christmas gift from my mom, and it's another penny shawl. So you get the idea of what it looks like. But instead of doing different color minis, I'm using leftover Malintosh yarn from a previous shawl project that I had a lot left over at a skein and just didn't really have a clue what I was going to use it for. So I'm using that for the sock weight portion on the shawl, and what was it called? The colorway. Well, you'll see. I doubt I will even have a chance to work on it by the time I record next, so you'll see. But anyways, yeah, so my Christmas knitting is starting early. I am, you know, last year I gifted everyone socks. So this year it's going to be a penny shawl for my mom, a penny shawl for my sister-in-law. This is the plan. It will probably change, but And instead of socks for my brother this time, I'm going to knit him a hat. I have been on a very strict yarn diet. I am pretty proud of myself because I have not cheated, except I've been on it since July. I have not bought yarn technically since July. However, for my part of my Christmas gift was a gift certificate at a yarn store that's in a town about an hour and a half away from where we live. It's in the same town my endocrinologist is at, so I try to go there whenever I have my appointment with him. And anyway, so they got me a gift certificate for the local yarn store. And anyways, I didn't really see anything that I wanted a whole bunch, but it's just, I didn't really see anything that I felt like I had to have and that I had to, like, break my yarn diet for, you know? Because, I got to thinking about it, I was like, you know, I've been pretty much, like, 6 months strong on my yarn diet, and my goal is to make it a year, so I don't really want to screw that up. So I ended up getting yarn that my brother has been talking about. My brother does not knit. He is not a fiber artist at all, but he is very much into wool. And by me saying into wool, he's not like a naturalist, if that's what they're even called. He's like, he really likes Bear Grylls, if you've ever heard of him. Bear Grylls is, Man of the Wild or something. He's got this show where he takes celebrities out to do survival stuff or whatever. I don't know, but he's into that. He's into that stuff, and he's into hiking and all that stuff. So he likes to get stuff that has, you know, some wool content in it. And anyway, so he had come across this yarn that's made with a New Zealand possum fur, and so they had some in their shop. And I cannot remember. It's like is a brand, or New Zealana. It's not New Zealand. It's just, but anyways, it's like a, I don't remember the exact content, and I should have brought it out because I didn't think that I'd be talking about it. That's the reason why I didn't. But it's merino and New Zealand possum for a blend. And New Zealand, for those who don't know, New Zealand possums are not the same as American possums. For one thing, they're much cuter. So, you know, I'm not knitting with American possum fur, but I kind of thought that. When he was talking about the possum yarn, I was like, ugh, what? But anyways, so I bought some of that yarn that I knew that he would absolutely love something to be made out of, and I'm going to knit him a hat. I have enough skeins, because it's kind of, that stuff's pricey, but I want to say it was like 20 something dollars for 50 grams, and it's DK weight, and it's not, a 50 gram skein is not enough to knit a hat out of. So I bought two skeins, and anyways, and then I used the leftover money on my gift card to buy wool wash, a whole bunch of wool wash. so as not to break the diet. But anyways, yeah, so I used his gift card that he gave me for Christmas to buy yarn to make him a gift for this Christmas. So I don't count that as cheating on my yarn diet, but anyways. Maybe you do. I don't know. You can tell me, but I don't think it's cheating. Anywho, two penny shawls, one for my mom, one for my sister-in-law for Christmas, a hat for my brother out of the possum yarn, socks for my dad, because he is just a sock fanatic. He loves the hand-knit socks, and probably a pair of socks for my husband, and I think I'm going to be knitting hats for my kids. And then socks for my brother's father-in-law and sister-in-law. Or no, father-in-law and mother-in-law. And yeah, so I gotta get busy. And all of this while also, you know, trying to have a life and a school life. So don't know if that's gonna happen. Don't know if all that knitting is gonna happen. But anywho. So, yeah, so that's the plan, and, so we've talked about stash. Obviously, there's not going to be any stash enhancement for a really long time. I'm pretty proud to say that. I just hope I still just stick to my guns about it. I have been extremely tempted. Desert Vista Dye Works has a new colorway out called Disco Duck. I don't know if anyone remembered Disco Duck, but I saw that. I loved Disco Duck when I was a kid. And I had one of those little Mickey Mouse record players. And anyways, my brother actually had a Disco Duck record vinyl. And anyways, so, but kind of passed down to me, and I used to listen to it all the time. And that kind of started my love for disco music. But it also started my love for Nancy Sinatra. My dad had a vinyl of Nancy Sinatra Boots album. And, I absolutely loved Nancy Sinatra. Actually, I still do. But anyways, all thanks to that little Mickey Mouse record player. But anywho, so she had has a new colorway called Disco Duck, and I was extremely, extremely tempted to buy a skein just for the name alone. And of course it's self-striping and stuff, and I even added it to my cart and stuff, and I was like putting in my information to check out, and then I was like no, and so I clicked the X button, exited out of there, and it was very hard. So I've been finding that I have been doing that. I will go to all these, you know, like on Etsy shops and stuff, and like look at yarn, and I'll add it to cart, and you know, it's satisfying just adding it to your cart and then just walking away and not actually buying it, you know. Well, at least that's what I tell myself. But that's how I'm right now fighting off the whole yarn temptation, and it is really strong right now. But I'm getting through it. Ugh. Anyways, I gotta knit my own yarn, right? I am a yarn dyer. I need to actually knit my own colorways. My husband's on me all the time about that. He's like, why don't you ever knit your colorways? You can use them for your shop samples and stuff and blah, blah, blah. And I was like, yeah, but look at all these other yarn, you know, all this other yarn out there that's pretty too. I am definitely not one of those dyers that only knit with my own yarn and no one else's. No, because to me, there's so much prettiness out there. Why would I not want to get it and knit with it? But anyways, so yeah, there's not really much going in the Ravelry group. Last year, we finished up the 2016 Stash Bust. I am not doing that this year. And the reason why, not that I don't want to do it again, it's more of having that commitment. Because, you know, I just got so much stuff going on right now. I'm still fighting my thyroid disease and stuff, even though that's starting to mellow out a little. But, you know, school and everything going, I don't want to commit to a year-long knit-along like that at this time. So, we're not doing Stash Bust this year. Of course, I do encourage to knit from your stash. That's what I've been doing myself. So, but I did open up a knit along for the Penny Shawl. It was free for the first day of its release, because I released it on my birthday. So I opened up the knit along, and it's gonna be a stress free knit along for it. It's basically just, there's not a deadline. There'll be prizes. It's just, I'll just randomly do them. Basically, like me, I thought about like doing like if there's one full page, which I think takes like 25 posts for a full page on each discussion topic on the Ravelry forums, doing it that way, or it might be like 1 of 25 or 1 of 50, I can't remember, but anyways, so I was thinking, well, once one pages full, just using the random number generator and going through there and picking the post. And, so that's going. Other than that, there's not a deadline for it. You just have to be a member of the TVNerdKnits group on Ravelry to be eligible for a prize. But yeah, other than that, that's it. I still have to get the prizes out for the Great Stash Bust. I think everything is out except for the yarn prize that goes to Amy F., Ravelry name, which I am going to be working that up this weekend. So, that's it, I think. Like I said, nothing really much to talk about. So if you have any comments, like the welcome back or whatever, I encourage them, of course. If you think like every 2 weeks or monthly recording, let me know. I'm thinking I'm probably more inclined to do the monthly, mostly because of finding the time and also content. Because I think if I do, definitely if I did it on a weekly basis, I wouldn't have anything to show you. And I'm not sure that I would have anything to show you if it was every 2 weeks. So let's try for every 4 weeks. Anywho, even though this is a shorter month, but it's not that short. I mean, I guess it's still technically 4 weeks. Oh, don't ask me to do math. Anyways. Yeah, so everyone have a great day. Have a great weekend. Enjoy Super Bowl if you're into that. I'm not, which is why I think I'm going to get plenty of knitting done because everyone else is in the Super Bowl. And oh, yeah, and happy Valentine's Day, too, for those who celebrate. Yeah, so anyways, see you later.